Tonight, world champions are revved up and set to soar in St. John. This week, the city of quads. On the runway, Elvis Stoiko, the innovator, father of the quadruple jump, still pushing his limits to the skies. Following in his quad steps, the new maestro, creating his own symphony on ice, Russia's Alexei Yagudin, world champion 2 years in a row, and only 19 years old. Flight night in New Brunswick. Next. Reflecting the historic city of St. John, New Brunswick, this week, Quad City for the 1999 Sun Life Skate Canada International. Oh, a busy night of skating here in the Maritimes as the crowd files into Harbor Station here in St. John. Hi, everybody. I'm Rod Black. We also have an exciting night of skating for you. We have the free dance ahead and the men's free skate. Let's go back to last night, though, and talk about this second stop in the Grand Prix series. It all began last week at Skate America when Elena Berezhnaya and Anton Tsigirlytsy inexplicably finished third. But last night, the two skaters, the two Russians, the world champions, put a rift behind them and skated beautifully. $30,000 richer in the gold medal. Canadian fans watching Canada's champions, Christy Sargent and Chris Wirtz, began the night in second place after the short program had a couple of glitches. They still ended up with the bronze. And in second place, Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman of the United States. Last week, Michelle Kwan of the United States captured the Skate America Championship. She'll be in the short program. We'll show you that from last night in a few moments. Jennifer Robinson, the Canadian champion, will also be in the field. The women's free skate goes tomorrow here in St. John. We'll have the free dance later in the show. Two Canadian teams, Marie-France Dubray and Patrice Lauzon, and Megan Wing and Aaron Lowe. Shailen Bourne and Victor Kratz are not competing here this week. They'll be competing next week. We'll have an interview with them from New York City a little later in the show. But tonight is also about the men. Eyes to the skies. We'll see a few quadruple jumps attempted here tonight. Alexei Yagudin and Elvis Stoiko head-to-head. And with more, here's Rob Pauls.
Rod, do you know that Elvis Stoiko's injury woes over the past couple of seasons have been well documented? He says he's 100% for 99-2000, but it was with great interest and perhaps a little concern this morning when it appeared that Elvis may have tweaked his left ankle. Elvis talked to us right after the practice and very quickly said, no, I'm fine.
Felt great today. Got a really nice quad triple down in practice, triple axle, triple toe. Just trying to rework all the, I guess, the muscles back into play. Yesterday I was quite tired. I guess the 2 weeks from competing and everything has been tough. But yesterday, kind of a down day. This practice just to gearing up and hopefully set up for tonight. Yesterday I was a little bit tight on one of the takeoffs and I have a little bit of a little sore tendon on my left foot, just a little bit. And it's more just tightness. And that's what I mean by reworking the muscles, because they've been tight from coming down. They get tired and you just want to rework them. They wasn't responding. It wasn't so much sore. It just wasn't responding the way I wanted it to. But by the end of the session, I went around, did quad triple, and went, it's responding fine. So then did another triple axle, triple toe, another triple axle, and went, it's there, it's back.
And a quick note about the ice. Alexei Yagudin went to the referee and asked whether or not there would be a flood between the two flights of men. They said no. Yagudin's concern is after the original dance and all the dancers that have been on the ice, there might be a problem, as in a lot of cuts or holes on the ice. Well, to that end, the people here at Harbor Station have done two scrapes and two very long floods to try to make the ice as smooth as possible. So the ice conditions might play a factor a little later on today.
All right, thank you, Rob. So once again, we're talking about Elvis Stoico with a potential injury, but let's talk about this quad-studded lineup tonight. And Elvis and Alexei, they went together in Colorado Springs last week. Alexei won gold, Elvis took the bronze.
And what's so interesting this year is the men have made a breakthrough in skating. Last year, we saw only a couple of quads completed successfully in the short program. Skate America, 3 quads landed. Also here in Skate Canada, 3 quads landed. The best quad of the competition was by the Chinese skater Zhen Zhang Li. He had a beautiful quad, straight up in the air, straight back. Here he is on the left of your screen. Good height, great speed on the landing. Now, Elvis Stoico tried the quad a number of times last year in the short program. First successful completion done here. And we've watched Alexei Yagudin of Russia, the current world champion, complete the quad 3 or 4 times already this year in the short program. He's making it look easy. Rod, what's fun to watch, though, is when you see all of them going at the same time. Watch the two, Elvis and Alexei. They look like they could be a pairs team. Perfect unison.
That's a quad triple, I think, right there. Let's talk about the free dance, which is ahead. Two Canadian teams who really don't have a shot at the gold medal, but are certainly looking at the podium with a shot at it.
Well, Dubray and Lauzon in fourth and Wingenlow in fifth do have a shot at a medal. The free dance is worth 50% of the total mark. And something to watch for tonight, the first time ever you'll hear vocals in the free dance in competition. It's going to be very entertaining.
Well, we'll have that a little bit later on. But first up, the women's short program from last night here in St. John. Here is the order of skate. Yulia Soldatova, Michelle Curry, Michelle Kwan, Yulia Sebastian, and Jennifer Robinson.
And as usual in the short program, there are 8 required elements. 3 jumps, including a double axel, a jump combination, and 3 spins, spiral sequence, step sequence.
The next competitor represents Russia, Julia Soldatova.
A common theme in Helsinki at the World Championships, Russians who were on the podium, and Julia Soldatova was one of them, finishing 3rd behind Maria Butyrskaya, who won the gold, and Michelle Kwan, who was 2nd.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be advised that all practices held on Sunday morning will be closed to the public. We thank you for your cooperation.
Yulia said nobody was more surprised than her. She went to Worlds hoping to be in the top 5, finished top 3. Here's her combination, triple lutz, double toe. Building now for a triple flip. A lean and a fall. She already has a 0.4 deduction for missing the triple flip. She'll need this, the double axel.
Yulia Soldatova, back in December 1997, won a World Junior Championship and captured that title right here in St. John, New Brunswick. Her marks in a moment, and still ahead, the incomparable Michelle Kwan. Bronze medalist of a 18-year-old from Moscow.
Well, Yulia started off very well with the combination rod. Here's a look at her backing into the Lutz. Picks in. She gets very good height on that, and then a clean double toe. Was not able to get the same kind of height in her other jumps. Here's a look at the flip, her triple flip. Reaches back. No, her toe pick slipped. You could see the lean. She didn't have a chance on that jump. Another area I think that Yulia needs to work on is her spiral sequence. This is a spiral position here, and you'll notice when Michelle Kwan does it, her leg is held way over her head with a beautiful extension. Watch here, Yulia. A nice variation on a spiral, but once again, when she finishes off, she doesn't have a beautiful spiral position, and that's a key element in this short program. Look at these marks. Low technical marks. 0.4 deduction for the fall.
On ice and in a building that she has fond memories of when she captured the World Junior Championship.
And those are very tough marks for a world bronze medalist.
5-4, 5-1, 5-3, 5-5, 5-4.
Thank you.
Our next competitor represents Canada, Michelle Curry.
Here is the 1999 Central Division champion for Canadian women. She was fifth at the Nationals last season. Here is 19-year-old Michelle Curry.
This is a huge competition for Michelle. Her first ever international competition. What a one to show up at, Skate Canada. Opening with a triple flip. Good attempt, stepped out. She needs this combination. Triple Lutz is her best jump. No. By Canadian judges back in the spring and could consistently show that she could land her triple Lutz, triple flip. Canadian Figure Skating Association trying to get stronger skaters at these internationals. Her first competition was supposed to be in the summer, but she tore a quad muscle, couldn't compete, and so here she is in her first competition. She showed us in practice she deserved to be here, but she is having trouble in this competition. Problems on the camel spin.
Well, there's nothing like skating on the big ice in the big leagues. International competition, first ever for Michelle Curry. We will see her at the Nationals in Calgary in the new year. Her dream, her goal is to do what Jennifer Robinson has done. She's to skate tonight, champion of Canada, and we'll come back to St. John. Mark is Michelle Curry, who trains and lives in Edmonton, Alberta, at the Royal Glenora Club.
And Rod, I've been very impressed with Michelle in practice, having no trouble with her jump. Good attempt at the triple flip. She was up over it. She turned out, and that is a .3 deduction. The Lutz, though, big fall, .4 deduction. Here she reaches in, picks up, didn't get the height that she needed to make the full rotation. And normally she has good lift in her jump. She's a very athletic skater.
Certainly has a good attitude. And
4-3.
Can't wait for the Nationals.
3-9, 3-6, 3-7.
Low marks, though, for required elements.
3-9.
This is all about experience, though, isn't it?
And what a big step it is to take your good jumps from the practice ice and put them out there in competition. It's a huge step to make. When she will have to do, though.
4-5.
Michelle Curry of Edmonton.
4-5. 4-5. Thank you. Our next competitor represents the United States, Michelle Kwan.
And here is the most famous Michelle in all of skating. One of the great skaters of all time. Second in the world, though, last season to Maria Butcherskaya. And wanting to regain a crown, she's won it twice, the world's. Here is the American champion.
Skating to a day in the life. Opens with an easy double axel. Here comes her combination, triple up, double toe loop. Good height, clean landing. Program of all the triples, it has the lowest degree of difficulty. It's the triple toe loop. Watch this spiral sequence. Flexibility and strength.
For just 19 years old, she has so much composure, so much finesse, and she has so many fans. Michelle Kwan, she should skate to some music by the Beatles. Her father named her after the song by the Beatles, Michelle. It's awesome. She really just,
I thought it was a nice,
whether she,
I mean, you know, it was
wins
accurate.
Gold medals or doesn't, she's got such a great attitude. She's a classy winner, and even classy sometimes in defeat when she doesn't do that well, but she just sizzles.
She came off the ice and said to her coach Frank Carroll, I felt trippy out there. He said, oh, you didn't look it. And no, she didn't look it. Let's look at the triple Lutz combination. I liked the lift and the height she got on that into the double toe. But my concern with her short program is that she does the triple toe for her jump, and there are so many other triples that can beat that rod that I think, looking ahead to World, she needs to up the ante, because this is a technical program. Look at the position on this layback spin. She gets a beautiful arch with her back, and see how high her leg is at the back? Great control and good center on it. Here's a triple toe loop that I was talking about. An easy jump. As far as triples go, she did get good height, but she said, you know, I have to have an on-the-money jump. I can't take the chance of making a mistake and then having the deduction.
Last year, did not compete in the Grand Prix Series. Look at the marks for required elements. 5-5, however, from one of the Canadian judges.
Yeah, and see, that's because of the technical difficulty. And if some of these women start landing a more difficult triple jump, they're going to beat her on that mark. As good as she is artistically, and there are some great marks for that. Rod, she is awesome. An all-round great skater. Nice role model off the ice.
Thank you. Michelle Kwan, and with Michelle Curry is Rob Falls.
Michelle, your first international competition. What's your reaction right now?
I'm happy to be here. It was fun. I had a lot of fun, and I wasn't really expecting the crowd to be together with my program and everything, and the clapping and the cheering. Lost a little bit on the Lutz, but it's okay overall.
What do you take then from this and build on for the future?
I think just knowing that Canada's a great crowd and they really support you, so, and I wasn't really expecting that much, so I just have to learn, you know, to keep my focus, and I hadn't missed the last all week, so.
Good luck to you.
Thank you.
This is the 19th ranked skater, at least she was, in Helsinki, Finland at the World Championships. Here is Yulia Sebastian from Hungary.
Best skate ever came at the European Championships in the short program in 1999 when she finished second. She could get incredible spring on her jump. Watch her triple Lutz. Whoa. Height, it reminds me of Midori Ito or Tanya Harding.
beautiful Thielmann spin. Yulia Sebastian of Hungary. Yulia Sebastian of Hungary.
For eight,
and a .4 deduction for the fall. She has yet to develop into a consistent jumper, but boy, Rod, has she ever got a lot of spring, and you can see it's going to be fairly easy for her to add next rotation and do a quad.
Another Hungarian, Christina Tako, a few years ago won this competition. Yulia Sebastian currently in third.
Thank you.
Jennifer Robinson getting the last words of encouragement from Coach Doug Lee.
Canada, Jennifer Robinson.
Two-time Canadian champion. Won the first one back in 1996, says it was unexpected. And then had to wait till last season before she was the best in her country again. A new season underway for Jennifer Robinson.
Choreographed by Michelle Kwan's choreographer, Lori Nickel. Opening with a double axel. Winding up for the triple lutz double toe combination. 2 foot landing, clean double toe. Touchdown is a .2, .3 deduction on the lutz.
Canada's women's champion last season, Jennifer Robinson from Windsor, Ontario. Hoping that this short program, the summer of 42, has some magic for her in the winter of 99.
I think she made everybody forget that she was doing a serious technical program. Cast a spell on this audience here.
And that was a pretty solid start for her.
Hey.
Her choreographer, Michelle Lee.
Hey, you're awesome. Thank you.
And Michelle's husband, Doug, yeah. Jennifer's coach.
Dan,
Ladies, Michelle and Doug, and of course this program choreographed by Lori Nickel from Keswick, Ontario, who does a lot of work also with the great Michelle Kwan.
And it suited her. Lori brought out the best of Jennifer in this program. Here's a look at the combination. Watch Jennifer's free leg. 2 foot landing there. That's a 0.2 deduction on the combination. But she showed incredible determination on the triple loop. Didn't look like she got a good takeoff at all. She didn't get the height she normally does. Often this jump just sinks. It didn't here. Barely got off the ice, but that showed incredible determination to be able to pull that out and land it.
Well, she has been known to fight a good fight, and her presence and confidence over the last few years have really grown and grown as she's matured into a well-polished skater, 22 years old now.
Well, when you can take a technical program and sell it in a competition like this one, that does show maturity, Rod.
So now the marks, and where will the judges place her? Pretty good marks, required elements. 4.943. That mark might be a little harsh.
5.2.
Deductions again on the combination.
But the presentation, look at that. And Jennifer Robinson is in second place, heading to the free skate ahead of the world bronze medalist, Yulia Soldatova.
5.5. Thank you.
So after the short program, Michelle Kwan of the U.S. number one, Jennifer Robinson, two Lori Nickel choreographed routines. Yulia Soldatova is third. Sylvia Fontana is fifth. And Michelle Curry in her first major international competition in eighth. Let's join Rob Falls.
Jennifer, you're in second place, and I think you're happiest with the fight you showed in that program.
Yeah, absolutely. I was feeling really good, though, this morning. I was a little bit nervous, just like usual in practice, but I calmed down tonight, and the loop was a little bit leaning, so I was really happy with the fight in the air, and I thought overall it was a pretty good program.
It seems that this Lori Nickel program suits you. It was a nice fit.
Yeah, I feel really comfortable when I get out there. It relaxes me. I really like to perform it, and it's my style, so it really fits really well.
Is this a good position for you to be in? You're in second. You're happy. Are you better off than you thought you might be?
Well, I was having pretty good practices all week, and I was having good results with the program, and I was getting good feedback, so I thought I had a pretty good shot, and I knew I just had to do my work. I still have a little bit more work to do tomorrow, and I'm thrilled to be where I am right now.
We look forward to seeing the next step.
Thank you so much.
That was